JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for October the 1st. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian morning Thursday. It lost the most ground versus NOK, Aussie, the Canadian dollar and the British pound in that order, while it underperformed the least against the Swiss franc, the yen and the euro. The weakness of the safe havens dollar and yen combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie suggest that the investors' appetite improved at some point yesterday. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that although most major EU indices closed in negative waters, all three of Wall Street's main indices traded in the green, closing on average 0.92% higher. The positive morale rolled over into the Asian session today as well, with Japan's Nikkei gaining 0.44%. China's, Hong Kong's and South Korea's markets were closed this morning. What may have helped investors to increase their risk exposure may be positive remarks with regards to a coronavirus aid bill in the US. Both House Speaker Nancy Pelosi and Treasury Secretary Steven Mnuchin expressed hope for a breakthrough in negotiations, with Mnuchin saying that talks made a lot of progress. Positive US data may have also boosted the risk appetite. Yesterday, the ADP reported that the private sector added 749,000 jobs in September after gaining 481,000 in August. This was above the market consensus of 650,000. On top of that, pending home sales accelerated to 8.8% month over month in August from 5.9%. instead of slowing to 3.2% as the forecast suggested, hitting a new record high. All this suggests that the US economic recovery remains on track despite COVID infections still rising at a fast pace. That said, we repeat that even though risk sentiment could stay supported for a while more, we are reluctant to trust a long-lasting recovery. The prospect of more lockdown measures around the globe remains well on the table, while as we get closer to the US election day, investors may start getting more nervous. For now, though, the next event that could enter the limelight is the official US employment report for September, due out on Friday. Expectations are for a decent report, something that could prove somewhat positive for the US dollar. The big question, though, is how the equity markets will respond. Will they continue gaining on signs that the economic recovery remains on track, or will they slide on speculation that the Fed may start raising interest rates faster than previously anticipated? After all, the latest dot plot revealed that four members saw higher rates in 2023 when the forecast for inflation is at 2%, suggesting that not all policymakers are in support of allowing consumer prices to overshoot their target for some time before they start raising interest rates. Now, as for today's events, today we get the final manufacturing PMIs for September from the Eurozone, the UK and the US. As it is the case most of the times, they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. From the US, we also get the ISM manufacturing index for the month, which is expected to have inched up to 56.2 from 56, as well as the personal income and spending for August and the initial jobless claims for last week. Personal income is forecast to have fallen 2.2% month over month after rising 0.4% in July, while spending is anticipated to have slowed to 0.7% from 1.9%. Initial jobless claims are forecast to have declined to 850,000 from 870,000 the week before. The core PCE index for August is also coming out, and it is expected to have ticked up to 1.4% year-over-year from 1.3%. As for tonight, during the Asian Morning Friday, we get Japan's employment report for August and Australia's retail sales for the same month. Japan's unemployment rate is forecast to have ticked up to 3% from 2.9%, while Australia's retail sales are expected to have fallen 4.2% month over month after rising 3.2% in July. We also have five speakers on the agenda: ECB Chief Economist Philip Lane, Bank of England Chief Economist Andy Haldane, New York Fed President John Williams, Philadelphia Fed President Patrick Harker, and Fed Board Governor Michelle Bowman. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.